Last night as I lay dreaming of pleasant days gone by, my mind been bent on rumbling to Ireland I did fly. I stepped on board a vision and followed with a will, and I shortly came to anchor at the cross of Spancil Hill. Delighted by the novelty, enchanted by the scene, wherein my early boyhood full often I had been, I thought I heard a murmur and I hear it still. It's the little stream of water that flows down Spancil Hill. To amuse a passing fancy, I lay down upon the ground, for all me old companions this shortly gathered around. When we were home returning, we danced with right goodwill to Martin Bowland's music at the fair of Spancil Hill. Being on the 23rd of June, the day before the fair, Ireland's sons and daughters and friends assembled there. The young, the old, the brave and the bold, they came to sport and kill at the parish church in Clooney, a mile from Spancil Hill. I went to see my neighbours to hear what they might say. The old ones were all dead and gone, the young ones turning grey. I met with the tailor quickly, he's as bold as ever still. Sure, he used to mend my breeches when I lived on Spancil Hill. I paid a flying visit to me first and only love. She's as white as any lily, she's gentle as a dove. She threw her arms around me, said, "Johnny, I love you still." As she's Mac, the ranger's daughter, the pride of Spancil Hill. I dreamt I held and kissed her, as in the days of yore. She said, "Johnny, you're only joking, as many's a time before. But the cock crew in the morning, it grew more loud and shrill, and I awoke in California, many miles from Spancil Hill."